Hi, do you remember how informative the first season of CBB 101 was? Well, the Central Bank of Barbados is back with a brand new series to help people like you and me understand the economy and the work of the bank. This time we'll be focusing on macroeconomic indicators, which is a big term, but you'll soon come to see it's quite simple and easy to understand. Let's kick off season two.
CBB 101, economics about you and me. CBB 101, economics about you and me.
Good day and welcome to season two of CBB 101, which will focus on macroeconomic indicators. In this series, we will explain the data that the bank uses to offer economic and financial advice. But in this first episode, we want to step back and make sure we're all on the same page about what we mean when we refer to the economy. We'll also discuss the key elements of Barbados' economy and how it functions. I'm Noveline Brewster, Chief of Corporate Communications, and joining me for the first few episodes is Professor Justin Robinson. Welcome, Professor. How are you?
Yes, fine, thank you. And yourself?
I am great. Let's start, Professor, by having you explain what do economists mean when they talk about an economy?
So that's an unfair question to start with. That's a tough one. But human beings, we produce and we consume goods and services just for basic necessity and to enjoy life. And the economy seeks to capture all of that. Now, for practical purposes, when we talk about the economy and GDP, what we end up capturing is the final market value of goods and services. So for something to be captured as in the official measures of the economy, it has to be a transaction or an activity where there is a price attached to it. So if you mow your lawn yourself, then that will not be captured formally in the economy. But if you hire someone and you pay them, that will be captured. So some people, for example, argue that economists undervalue the work of women. Women do a lot of work in the household, but there's no price, there's no final market value. So I don't know if that answers your question.
To some extent. So basically what you're saying is that some sort of pay has to be involved.
Yes. And even the nature of the pay can influence it. Because if you just pay the person cash, and that cash doesn't find its way into the banking system or some formal, then we may not capture that in the official measure. So you might hear the term the informal economy. So these are transactions that take place. So I guess I'm at the central bank. So, you know, a tourist comes off a plane, gets onto a taxi, pays the taxi man with some pounds sterling. That taxi man then gives those pounds to his daughter going back up to the UK. Economically, that didn't happen. So even though there was pay, it was never captured in any of the formal mechanisms. And that's what we mean by an informal economy. So some economies are actually larger than the way you actually measure them. If you have economies where there's a lot of subsistence, a lot of things, people do things in kind, they do things for each other, there is economic activity, but there is no final price, there's no market value, and there may be no official record of it. So it doesn't exist, but the economic activity has and is taking place.
So when we talk about the formal economy, then that information or that transaction is captured. So if I went to a store downtown, that is part of the formal
exactly.
economic activity that we are referring to.
And then
to.
You know, so you are paid a salary. That's what central bank records. That gets captured in income tax, NIS, and when you do your expenditures, they have to do VAT and all of that. So that's what we capture. So it has to enter into some sort of official record to be captured as an official part of the economy.
Do we have any idea at all, though, how big the informal economy is in Barbados? And is there really need to start measuring that in some way?
Yeah, so there have been some studies putting it from anywhere from 5 to 25%. But I would say compared to a lot of Caribbean economies, the informal economy here is relatively smaller. But Barbados is a country where there's a significant NIS coverage, a high level of formal employment. So if you go to a country like India, for example, about 80% of Indians work in the informal economy. So Barbados, if you flip it, maybe no more than 20. We might suspect that a lot of our informal economy are things we don't talk about in polite conversation. Activities that people do not want to be captured formally.
We also hear a lot, Professor, about the small open economy. Help us understand what you mean when you talk about Barbados being a small open economy.
Okay, so small, I think, explains itself. It's a relatively small size. Open tends to refer to the percentage of your economic activity that is driven by foreign trade. So, for example, if you go downtown Barbados to buy anything, maybe 80% of what you can buy comes in from outside. Now, if you go in the USA, for example, even though there are a lot of imported goods, the vast majority of goods are produced openly. And if my memory serves me correctly, in terms of trade openness, it'd be more like 20-25% of the goods traded in the US that come from outside the US. So we are small in size, I think everybody understands that. And open means that a large chunk of our economic activity depends on and is linked to international trade. You know, we don't have oil, you bring in oil. You know, my computer in front of me, the clothing we wear, a lot of the food. So that's what makes us open, the high level of trade dependence.
Let's spare just 1 or 30 seconds to explain the implications of this high level of trade dependence for Barbados.
Okay, so one of the, and it's something the central bank worries a lot about, and it's maybe the numbers that we place the most emphasis on. It means that to run Barbados, to live in Barbados, we need to have constant, ready access to foreign exchange. Because trade openness means that you are buying a lot of the goods and services you need to sustain life, limb, your quality of life. And once you're getting it from outside of your country, then you need foreign exchange. So with trade dependence comes foreign exchange dependence, and we often think that foreign exchange is the lifeblood of the economy. Because you know, you want a new flat screen TV, you have to import it, you need the foreign exchange. But you want a life-saving medicine, it's not made here, you have to get it in from outside, and you need the foreign exchange to facilitate that. So we often think other economies, people look at GDP, unemployment, inflation, and these are all very important metrics. But because we are small and open, we often think that the availability of foreign exchange is the critical element in Barbados.
Finally, let us wrap this by having you explain to our viewers why he or she should pay attention to how an economy functions and how the Barbadian economy functions.
You are part of the economy. So I don't think people have to. Once you are alive, you are producing, consuming goods and services. So you are a part of the economy. What's happening with the economy has a direct impact on the quantity, the quality, and the prices of the goods and services that you will have to sustain your life, your limb, and for your entertainment and enjoyment of life. I mean, it's a classic example here now, where the price you have to pay at the pump for something, that's a function of what's happening in the economy, because the price you pay depends on what's happening with the demand and supply of oil, government policy in terms of taxes and so on. So I would say you should pay attention, because the economy has a direct impact on the quantity, quality, and the prices of the goods and services you need to live. It has a direct impact on the amount of income you can earn to sustain yourself and your family. And if you live in a place like Barbados, it also has a direct impact on the ability of the government to provide a certain quantity and quality of services like education, healthcare, garbage collection. So it is an integral part of your life.
Thank you. It definitely is. This is where we will wrap this episode of CBB 101. Before we go, let's hear what our key takeaways are.
The economy captures the final market value of goods and services produced and consumed in the country. Barbados has a relatively small informal economy, with no more than 20% of people working in the informal economy. And Barbados's high dependence on international trade means it needs ready access to foreign exchange.
So in many ways, real GDP growth, inflation, unemployment, in an economic context, those are the equivalent of your blood pressure, your heart rate, and your blood sugar.
CBB 101, economics about you and me. CBB 101, economics about you and me.